नमस्ते जी, नमस्ते। वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस लॉ, टाउन एरिया कमेटी वर्सेस प्रभु दयाल केस लॉ फ्रॉम 1975। व्हाई आर वी स्टडिंग दिस केस? याद है हमारे भैया फ्रॉम एलएलबी एंट्रेंस, डैमनो साइने इंजूरिया, राइट? डैमनो साइने इंजूरिया, दिस केस लॉ रिलेट्स टू दैट कॉन्सेप्ट। लेट अस सी व्हाट इट्स ऑल अबाउट। वी आर बीइंग टॉट दिस सो दैट वी अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट वेरी वेल। द प्लेंटिफ, ही कंस्ट्रक्टेड अराउंड 16 शॉप्स एट अ बिल्डिंग, और आर द ओल्ड फाउंडेशन ऑफ अ बिल्डिंग कॉल्ड एज गड़ी, एंड देन द टाउन एरिया कमिटी बेसिकली डिमोलिश इट बिकॉज इट वॉज एन इलीगल कंस्ट्रक्शन। सो ही सूड देम फॉर डैमेजेस। ही सेड, आई हैव सफर्ड अ डैमेज ऑफ 1,000 रुपीज, यू हैव डिमोलिश माई शॉप्स इलीगली। सो डिफेंडेंट नंबर वन एंड डिफेंडेंट नंबर टू वर चेयरमैन एंड वाइस चेयरमैन, एंड द मेन डिफेंडेंट वॉज द टाउन एरिया कमिटी, बेसिकली यू कैन से द म्युनिसिपल अथॉरिटी। नाउ डू यू नीड टू, वॉट ऑल डू यू नॉट नीड टू रिमेंबर? यू कैन एक्चुअली, अगर एग्जाम में ये बात याद नहीं आती, जैसे कि ये बिल्डिंग का नाम क्या था, कुछ नहीं, आपको ओवरऑल मैक्रो तरीके से यू विल हैव टू बेसिकली एक्सप्लेन द केस। ऑलराइट, सो प्लेंटिफ्स केस वाज दैट, हे बडी, अंडर द सेक्शन 186 ऑफ यूपी म्यूनिसिपल एक्ट द नोटिस वाजंट सर्व। नाउ बी केयरफुल, इफ यू फॉरगेट दिस सेक्शन, इट इज एब्सोल्युटली ऑल राइट। द एग्जामिनर इज इंट यू नो रियली लुकिंग, एग्जामिनर ने खुद नहीं पढ़ी होगी कभी यूपी म्यूनिसिपल एक्ट। सो यूपी म्यूनिसिपल एक्ट के अंदर अगर आप ये भूल जाते हैं कि यार कौन सी एक्ट थी या क्या था, ऑल दैट यू कैन राइट इज अंडर द रेलेवेंट एक्ट। सो रीफ्रेम इट, बी स्मार्टर। अंडर द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द रेलेवेंट एक्ट, द प्लेंटिफ कंटेंटेड दैट आई वाज नॉट सर्व्ड अ नोटिस एंड इट वाज ओनली अ नोटिस ऑफ 2 आवर्स, व्हिच इज नॉट अ रीजनेबल टाइम अंडर सेक्शन 302, एंड इट वाज सर्व्ड व्हेन आई वाज आउट ऑफ स्टेशन, सो द एक्शन वाज मैलिफाइड। दिस इज प्रीटी मच द प्लेंटिफ्स कंटेंशन हियर। ऑलराइट, सिंस वी आर स्टडिंग टॉर्ट्स, so well this is pretty much, you know, I want money for this, right? So all of this, actually to tell you very honestly, it's practically impossible to remember all of this, kyunki aap kya kya yaad rakhenge, you know, you can't be expected to remember the provisions of a UP municipal act. If you do remember them in exam, great, but if you don't, reframe it and be smarter. And wahan pe jaake in the exam when you're writing the answer, then don't photo your sir ki are oh meko to yaad hi nahi aa raha mera answer galat hai, nahi. That's not that. We are testing you on damnos and injuria basically, and we are coming to that right now. Defendant ka case is, well, we gave you a defendant ka case is, it was a construction without notice under the same UP Municipal Act under section 178 and 180. You didn't take any sanction from us, so the town area committee is now saying this in court. Well, humare se koi sanction bhi to nahi liya tha inhone, right? We gave you a prior notice to stop. You never complied with our warnings. Then the district magistrate ordered it, right? Ordered who? They ordered the town area committee to demolish your shops under section 186. So how exactly are we wrong here? All right. So the court said the ratio in this, basically the lower appellate court awarded damages to the plaintiff. This is basically a higher court there. So the lower appellate court misunderstood the case and basically your decision is wrong. The court overturned it. And this is the key line that you will have to write, that the plaintiff is entitled to compensation only if he suffers an injury because of an illegal act. Right? Now, in the damno sine injuria concept, you don't have any right to compensation if you have not suffered a legal injury. So you have suffered a damage, right? Your shops have been demolished, but those shops were illegal to begin with. So how exactly are we going to compensate you for that? All right. Your shops were illegal. You never complied with the notices. On top of it, the district magistrate ordered your destruction of shops. And well, guess what? You're dead now. राइट, तो इसीलिए आपको, यू डोंट हैव एनी राइट टू कॉम्पेंसेशन, यू हैव सफर्ड अ डैमेज, श्योर योर शॉप्स हैव बीन, यू नो, इट बीन, दे हैव बीन डिमोलिश्ड, बट इन दी हैव यू सफर्ड अ लीगल इंजरी? सो उबी जैसी बी रेमेडियम, एशबी वर्सेस वाइट में हमने किया था, इफ देर इज अ राइट देर इज अ रेमेडी। यहाँ तो आपका कुछ हुआ ही नहीं, क्या रेमेडी दें हम आपको? सो डैमनो साइन इंजूरिया में तो वैसे भी टॉर्ट का केस लगता नहीं, एलएलबी एंट्रेंस, टिंग टिंग टचिंग, पीछे से आवाज आई, right? So you don't have any right to compensation here. And I believe, you know, it's a common sense. I really don't know how the lower appellate court, I don't know which judicial exam do these judges clear, ya kaun si yahan pe kya chalta hai, ulta seedha tact, and how can they even give such a decision? It's pretty much that simple. So why have you been taught this case law? What is the purpose that has been included in your case, man? so that you understand the concept of damage loss and injuria, and you have to write this line that you are entitled to compensation if you suffer an injury because of an illegal act, right? So the court said, you know, plaintiff is arguing that he was not given a reasonable time. Correct? Yahi to main argument hai that you are not given a reasonable time. But time does not matter if it is an illegal action, subsequent legal action is taken. Illegal action was what? The shops being constructed. Legal action is you were sent two notices and then the DM also ordered, you know, all of this is a legal process. So they have complied with all legal provisions and herein you are suing them for torts. Okay. So subsequent legal action mein aapke paas there is absolutely no right to compensation. And then Vakil Saab basically must have gotten tired for the plaintiff. He said, no, no, but I also have a right to property. Court said, get out. What do you mean you have a right to property? You'll construct any shop at any building at any illegally encroach upon public land. Sorry, not happening. The right to property argument went out. The court said you not suffered an injury. Actually, the plaintiff's lawyer argued that, you know, we have suffered an injury. And court said, kaise? Apne aap hi. Kuch bhi. Right? So this is pretty much the case. That's it. So in the answers, यहाँ पे नहीं ज्यादा फोकस करना है, यहाँ पे नहीं फोकस करना, सेक्शन 186, सेक्शन 302, सेक्शन 170 कितना याद कर लेंगे, यू हैव लाइक 25-30 ऑड केस लॉज इन पर सब्जेक्ट टू रिमेंबर, राइट? यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस डैमेज एंड इंजुरी, और इसको एक्सप्लेन करके आइएगा, इसको खींचेगा, तभी एक्टिव में लिखिएगा, समटाइम्स राइटर एंड पैसिव, सो दैट इवन इफ द एग्जामिनर इजंट यू नो रियली रीडिंग योर आंसर, यू विल स्टिल एंड अप स्कोरिंग रियली गुड मार्क्स. सो द पर्पस ऑफ दिस सीरीज इज स्कोर गुड मार्क्स एक्चुअली. Right, based on my own experience of how do these examiners function, because you know they have like what 1500 answer copies to evaluate. You think they're going to sit down and read each and every detail? Yeah, sure enough, you can elaborate on the facts, good, but don't crack your skull open ki mujhe kuch yaad hi nahi, meko fact hi nahi yaad. Utni detail mein yaad nahi, broadly bhi bata denge that there were some illegal shops that were being constructed, the down area committee was sued, and then they were fighting about reasonable time, and then get into the concept of why the judge saab gave this decision, or rather why were you made to study this case law to begin with, and I believe then life will be very very simple for you in your exam. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Theek hai ji, now see you in the next one, which is Sidharamaya, then we go to Lakshmi Salt Water, then go to Rallin versus Fletcher, basically cover out all important case laws from the subject of torts. All right, see you.